course, there's not only the 800 version of new BMW's new F-Series off-roaders, there's also this F650GS, a bike which, although based on the 800 twin, gets the 650 name, sorry, because it's the intended replacement for the old and popular entry-level F650GS single. The new bike gets basically the same engine as the 800, except it's been tuned with softer cams to give it a slightly more gentle delivery. It's got more road-orientated wheels, smaller front wheel cast alloy, so it's a bit more road-orientated. More basic conventional forks, less travel. The same exhaust system, the same swing arm, but a slightly different rear shock. Again, different wheel and tyre at the rear. Chain drive like the 800. Big underseat tank like both models again. Same seat as the 800 essentially, but because of this different suspension and it's much lower than on the 800GS, so it's much more friendly for ladies and novice riders and things like that, and it's actually much easier to straddle. And at the front end, you get a smaller screen, although you can put that from the GS onto it if you like as an extra. You get the same, essentially the same bodywork, although the GS version has got more sort of off-road enduro style bits and pieces here and there. The sat nav is again an option. Same clocks, although it's telling that the GS, which is slightly peakier, slightly more potent power delivery, would quite happily top out at about 200 kph or about 120 miles per hour, whereas the softer tuned 650 was really running out of steam at about 180 kph, and it wouldn't pull to the red in sixth gear. Sixth gear on this bike is a bit more of an overdrive, really. And that's it, all for about 5,600, which is good value for a twin, a BMW, with all the BMW creature comforts and backup and residuals and peace of mind. And like the old GS, it feels very similar to the old 650 GS in many ways, even though it's a single. From the saddle, it's very familiar, very friendly, very easy to get on with. Well done, BMW.